Okay, we're all hearing a lot about artificial intelligence lately, and it can be pretty confusing. But not to worry, help is here. Welcome to AI Adventurers, our video series starring Minecraft's own Agent and Chicken. Together, they explore the fascinating world of artificial intelligence, beginning with what is AI and how does it work?
Finding information used to be a lot like fishing. You had to search in so many different places. And if you didn't look in the right place, you wouldn't find what you were looking for. But today, you can use the power of AI, artificial intelligence, to help you search for information. AI is a technology people created that can do many things, including helping come up with ideas and solutions for big problems. It's a bit hard to explain, so Chicken has volunteered to help. Yes, you. First, programmers have to teach the AI model. That's like Chicken training on huge amounts of information about lots of different things. Once that's done, the AI model starts to find patterns in the information it's been given. Like, books about tigers often mention cats, but websites about cats rarely mention cars. Pictures of cars often include dogs, but scientific studies about dogs almost never mention saxophones. And once the AI has found millions and millions of patterns, it can start making predictions. Like the prediction that fish are unlikely to be found in trees, or in fields, or in mugs of water, or even in puddles. But also the prediction that fish do live in large bodies of water, like rivers and lakes. Now, sometimes AI systems make mistakes. For example, whales do not live in lakes, so we should always double check what AI is telling us. AI is very new, and like most technology, it's being improved all the time. Okay, Chicken, you can relax now. Thanks for your help. What do you think AI will be able to do next?
Wow! Thanks, you two, for showing us how AI models are trained, what they're good at, and why you should always check your results. And now with that under our belt, let's take a look at AI in action and get some tips on how to use AI tools responsibly.
Hey, what are you watching? Ooh, a trick shot. Those are fun. You know what? You could use AI to help you design your own trick shot. Make it awesome. Show me the idea. Okay, so you throw the ball. It would bounce off the Eiffel Tower, rebound off the Great Wall of China, then bounce off the statues on Rapa Nui? Wait, that's impossible. You can't throw a basketball around the world. What kind of AI system did you use to come up with that? Oh, no. You can't use the AI model in your car's GPS to help you plan a trick shot. That AI model helps you find your way around by giving you directions. You need the right tool for the task. To help create a trick shot, you need generative AI, like a chatbot. Go get 'em! Okay, let's see what you got. You bounce the ball off the floor, and the ball goes right through the hoop. Huh, that's not very exciting. Wait, did you ask it to just make a basket? Ah, okay, that's the problem. Generative AI is great at coming up with ideas, but it only does what you tell it to do. You need to give it detailed instructions about what you're looking for. That will help get better answers. And be sure to review what the AI tells you. Make it your own. Oh, this looks exciting. Let's do it. This is great. Oh no, the AI was wrong about that last bounce. The basketball is off course. Chicken, what are you doing? Will it work? Unbelievable! That was the best trick shot ever! You used the right AI system for the task, gave it detailed instructions, and then used your own knowledge and ability to make a trick shot that's truly your own. Now that's how to use AI responsibly.
Great trick shot! And a great example of using the right tool for the task. You both used AI creatively and responsibly. Slam dunk! Speaking of being creative, there are many ways to use AI tools to create content, but you also have to be on the lookout for content that others make that could be deceptive. Let's take a look as Agent and Chicken try using AI to help them build something awesome and realistic.
Agent and Chicken want to build a treehouse, so they're looking for ideas online. Wow, look at that one. It's almost too good to be true. Wait a minute. There are AI-generated images out there, and it can be really hard to tell if a picture is fake. But let's take a closer look at this one anyway. Huh, this treehouse looks kind of weird. Like, this door doesn't go anywhere. And those columns look impossible. Whoa, wait, what's happening? I will say that is a beautiful balcony, but, Chicken, I think you're upside down. Look out! Hey, are you okay? You fell off the couch. Oh, come on, you two. Don't be disappointed. That image wasn't real, but AI can still help you. That's right. Ask AI, how can I build a safe treehouse? Nice! Look at those AI results. Detailed instructions on how to build a treehouse, materials you need, and how to make it safer. You know, I wouldn't have thought of putting a safety net there, but that's a great idea. Hey, wait a minute. Even though AI can be very accurate, you always have to cross-check the information with other reliable sources. Hey, are those the building birds? I love them. I've been following them for years. They build cool tree houses that are chicken certified for safety. I think we can trust what they have to say. Look at them go. You know, it looks a lot like the treehouse the AI described, but, oh yeah, those steps are better than the ladder. And having a guardrail there makes a lot of sense. So I think with the information from AI and the reference video, you're ready to start building. Good luck. You two have outdone yourselves. That looks amazing. What are you thinking now? Oh, you don't think this treehouse looks as cool as the first one? Well, maybe not, but this one is something you could actually build, and it has that awesome safety net. You're right. Now that you've built a real treehouse, you can use the AI image as inspiration for decorating. It will still be safe, and now it will look extra fun, too. Great job.
Bingo! That was a great example of how to use generative AI responsibly. A very important lesson to learn, as today more and more people are integrating AI into their daily lives. But what about tomorrow? And the day after that? Let's join Agent and Chicken as they discover how artificial intelligence will be able to help us solve real-world problems in the future.
Artificial intelligence, or AI, may feel brand new. But some forms of AI have been around for a while, and we use them every day. Like robot vacuum cleaners, they use AI to find their way around. And when you use facial recognition to unlock your tablet, that uses AI too. Wow, it would be amazing to visit a coral reef. Now a new type of artificial intelligence is beginning to help us in lots of ways. For example, AI software developers are working to make it easy for anyone to create their own chatbot to help get personalized answers. Oh, Chicken's chatbot found a great place to go diving. And although a few places already have self-driving taxis, we're going to see a lot more of them as AI makes them better and better. And AI will play a huge part in how we understand the world around us. For example, scientists are studying ways to use AI models to learn more about our oceans, like making mini submarines that can identify fish, and then use AI to decide to follow a certain one to learn more about it. And who knows what the future holds? Some scientists think that with the help of AI, we'll someday even be able to understand how dolphins communicate. AI is a very powerful set of tools. It's up to all of us to learn how to use AI safely and responsibly so it can help us solve big problems.
That's it. We've learned what artificial intelligence is, what it can and can't do, and how to use it properly and responsibly. Oh, but before you go, just a note. Agent and Chicken have been terrific guides to the basics of AI, but there's still so much more to learn. To help with that, we've created in-depth lesson plans and other resources for educators and parents. You'll learn how to get the most from AI while avoiding the pitfalls. It's all on our website. Well, thanks for joining us, and good luck on your own AI adventures. Okay, bye. Chicken's gotta fly, and hosts gotta swim.